Hello guys, Steel here. Welcome to another episode of SD Gundam G-Generation Genesis playthrough. So last episode we pretty much just wrapped up the Lost War Chronicles. It ended up pretty good actually. Both Ken and Matt did not really die, so it's not really tragic in that sense. But yeah, less on that, more on our new series. Moving on to the latter phase of the 1 year war is a perspective of these guys. Side story Space Beyond Blaze featuring Ford. So let's just begin actually, and since the enemies are starting to scale off, I'm gonna try doing this in hard mode.
地球から最も遠いコロニー軍サイド3を本国とするジオン公国は地球連邦政府に対して独立戦争を仕掛けました。未曾有の規模となったこの戦争は人類50数億の命を奪い地球に大規模な気象変動を引き起こしてなお今も続けられています。当初より連邦軍はジオン公国の新兵器モビルスーツにより圧倒され続けましたが、連邦も独自のモビルスーツ開発の成功を機に30倍もの物量を生かした一大反抗作戦を決行。
30-fold resource advantage. Why would Zeon try to fight that? And for what reason?
連邦軍が追いかける形で戦場は地上から宇宙へと移ることになったのです。そして宇宙世紀 00079 12月2日、連邦軍はジオン公国の本国であるサイド3攻略を最終目標とし、ジャブロー基地より連邦軍第二連合艦隊を宇宙に向けて発進。その宇宙艦隊の先行部隊として準ホワイトベース級
Thoroughbred
サラブレッドを機関とする第16独立戦隊があったんです。
So far we have the white base to the blank rival to the Thoroughbred and then to the Albion.
28シリーズすなわち2つのガンダムを搭載していたのです。
Not piloted by new type though.Captain, G-04 and G-05 have both been loaded, ending the simulation battles. Good. Unless something arises, we should have the pilot meeting in an hour. Could you pass that along, Petty Officer Takizawa? Yes, sir, Captain Kirsten. I'll also tell them about your concerns, Captain. Ah, thank you. Actual combat is not far off. They'll play a central role for this fleet. They'd better hold it together.Yes. Captain Kirsten's right to be worried. The experimental unit creating the next generation high mobility space MS at the Augusta base was suddenly summoned to Jabro and attached to the Thoroughbred fleet due to a change in war situation. Okay, I'm assuming that's the Madrock. Now that this long and brutal war is finally drawn to a close, the decision to deploy these two newly developed high-mobility space combat Gundam G-04 and G-05 shows that Revel is serious about ending the war. And there goes Annie, transferred to these guys from the... What was it? Third Special Corps?I forgot the number and what's it called, but they're test corps. Talking about Matt and co. Hey, what are you doing? You call yourself an ace pilot? You're abusing that machine. Geez, think about all the maintenance work involved. I mean, show some respect for your machine. What's wrong, Annie? Lieutenant Fold, aka Ford, Fold's Unit 5 is running its verniers for no reason. When you go back to space, you have to worry about the load on all the joints. There's higher potential, so you have to compensate. And the target was already destroyed. Why not stop there, right, Miu? Annie's explanation is right. Lieutenant Luth's Unit 4 is using half the fuel you're using. I have more experience in space, that is all. Well, everyone pilots their mobile suits differently. If I worry about fuel all the time, I'll lose my hair like Luth. Hold, you jerk. I was defending you. Well, he does make a point. He doesn't have hair in his front. He just goes to show the value of Lieutenant Luth's experience piloting space fighters. Unit 4 checks out just fine. You could learn a thing or two from this guy, Mr. Fancy Pants Test Pilot. What was that? Calm down there, Ford. You're a good Gundam pilot yourself, Lieutenant Ford. I don't know how to put this into words, but there are things that you can do that I lack. I've noticed this while training with you. There's no doubt about it. So is that about it? The captain seems pretty worried, you know. What? Did he say something about me? Oh, this won't do. Whatever, I'll prove myself to him in actual combat. He'll see what I'm capable of. The meeting's in an hour, so... Understood. Later. Later, where are you going? We only have 1 hour to rest, right? I'm exhausted. I'm gonna take a nap. Piloting takes a lot of strength. An elite soldier only needs a short time of rest. Yeah, I know. Jeez, shut up already. You know, Ford's the troublemaker kind of type. Not responsible at all. Definitely not the leader. The main Federation fleet has launched from Jabro and is currently being supplied at Luna 2. This fleet is starting to move out as part of the Operation Shembalo. In other words, it's a massive operation. Huh? As you know, both Solomon and Granada on the moon are necessary to attack the Zeon homeland. Whichever one the Federation attacks, the enemy will send massive reinforcements from the other. True, so we'll need to keep both of them in check. To prevent them from hitting our fleet from behind. Our mission is to protect the main fleet's rear by monitoring the Granada lunar base. Granada is a factory city built by Zeon on the moon's surface. Its output is crucial to Zeon. They must have significant forces in reserve. Got it. So we're smashing Granada, right? We don't have nearly enough strength to take on Granada. Oh. As both of you know, in addition to the high mobility space types mobile suit G04 and G05, this ship also includes systems that allow it to evade detection. In other words, mobility and stealth are our forte. Right. We have to make the most of these capabilities to prevent enemy forces from hitting the fleet from behind. That is our mission. I see, sucker punch the enemy, huh? It's the basic strategy for pitting a small force against a larger one. It will be dangerous, however, so a lot is riding on you and your two Gundams. We know it, and we'll do it. Just leave it to us. The enemy? That was quick. Enemy fleet approaching. Musai class, light cruisers, and mobile suits. Based on the size and heading, must be a scout fleet. We can't let them find we're here. Attack them before they can send a message to the Granada or Solomon. Disperse Minovsky particles immediately. Gundam 4th and 5th, prepare to launch. Got it. G05, standing by. This will be the squadron's first combat. Be careful. I know. Ford Ron Fellow, moving out. Listen to me, Ford. You've barely faced combat yourself, so don't do anything crazy. Not do anything crazy? You're crazy to say that. Just do what you always do. Do exactly what you've done in training and you cannot lose. I can't figure out that much. Miu, that is enough. Forward's a full-fledged pilot, okay? Yeah, give it a rest. Here's the situation and mission objective. We're moving through the former Side 2 Shoal Zone. We've discovered a Zeon fleet in front of us. The enemies are Musais with several mobile suits. It looks like a scout fleet. And their movements? They don't seem to have noticed us. Therefore, a surprise attack may be possible. Here's how we'll do it. First, we'll disperse Minovsky particles to make sure the enemy fleet cannot communicate with Granada. Next, our mobile suits will launch and hit the enemy in one fell swoop. So it'll be all about speed. The key to this operation will be using the mobility of the G04 and G05 in a hit-and-run attack. If they call for reinforcements or report our position, that will be a setback for our operations. Please accomplish this mission with that in mind. Gotcha, ma'am. Alright. Hey, try to put a lid on it, Forward. Those are our Musai class. Minovsky density rising. Alert, alert. Federation bastards are definitely in the area. Find them. Well, we are on stealth, so... I see him, Ford. No time to screw around. You don't have to tell me that. The enemy's already on alert. Those Zeon guys are used to space, and it shows. Nah, man. We can do this, too. Enough. This all goes without saying. Who do you think I am, anyway? I was the ace in my last unit. Let's just hope you're not rusty. Just don't cry if you cannot keep up. The beams are concentrated in the middle, going from the side. Yeah, yeah, I got it. Now get ready to be wowed by my kill count. Alright, ambushed by DOMS already? What are you doing, Ford? You're out too far. It's perfect for my first prey. I don't need your help. You're totally bonkers. I can't relax and fight watching you do that. Damn. Got the responsible guy partnered with the opposite. But at least... Definitely... It is a prologue stage, so... Let's review. So Ford has to defeat 5 units. I know the difference between... They're almost exactly the same, right? The difference between the G4 and 5th, they're both range units, and G4 focuses more on beam weapons while G5 goes with artillery. But this has an hyper beam rifle as well, so... Well, bullseye. You gotta be careful in hard mode though, cause... Not that they only have much more HP and mobility, they attack... Their attack output is higher too. So... Just gotta be a little bit more careful. But the Gundams are pretty strong, so... There's less thing to worry about in this. That's 2 kills for Ford. Let's make it 3. Surprisingly, even in hard mode, this prologue stage is pretty simple. Just literally what word says, you just gotta have to mow them out. Mow them down. And we wanna avoid getting hit by a Musai class. Only kill one more, and we're good for the challenge part. Free 5k. The pilots should be better in hard mode too. Well, I'm guess these guys are just too strong. At least Luke have more range, which is good. Oh, that's awesome. It's pretty good. And dealt 25k collectively. It's the kind of animations I'm looking forward to. Simple but awesome. Okay, three more traps set up for the prologue. Enemy defeated, all units destroyed. How do you like that, Luke? I took out the most enemies, did I not? Ford, it's not about the numbers. Enemy fleet confirmed destroyed. Looks like we prevented any communication with the moon or Solomon. Looks like our stealth capabilities are the real deal. Lucky for us to have you and those Gundams on board. Thank you, Captain. This should make things easier on us. Like how Zeon's Zaku's changed everything. This feels like the start of a new generation. Guess I'm a relic of the past now. But you have no intention of losing though, right? Of course not. Petty Officer Takizawa, bring the Gundam 4th and 5th back home. Zeon should start moving immediately once they realize they've lost touch with that scout fleet. We have to leave this sector before they arrive. Yes, understood. And then set up the... Yes, another special meeting. Zanzibar? It's definitely a Federation Trojan horse type. The perfect quarry for me, Marit Sanguine, the one chosen by fate for victory. But Lieutenant Marit, this is a pretty tough enemy. Not just a Trojan horse, but two new mobile suits that might be the rumored Gundam. The Federation can't make mobile suits for crap. Maybe you're just scared, human. Is that it? The problem is the pilots. Their fighting skills are formidable. Better than mine? You can't be saying that, can you? I see it as an opportunity. Yeah, Gustar Piper. Looks like a pretty boy. Beating them will do a lot of our squadron's rep. There might be promotions and reward in it for us. Let's get him, boss. We certainly will. But Master Marit, is this okay? What do you mean, Flaubert? I mean, what if Granada blames you for not protecting that scout fleet? You snake, are you trying to cover your ass at my expense? No, sir. I'm sorry, sir. I take it back, sir. We're going back to Granada, immediately. Time to pick up you know what. Lady Cassilia will be pleased once we destroy them. Time for our new Zeon to be born. Yeah, another Zeon chick pilot. definitely gonna make my idol group now. So for that I need 8 or 9 with the master unit. Lieutenant Junior Grade Ford, Romfellow, what exactly did you think you were doing out there? Our ship does not have 2 Gundams so we can compete with each other. It's so we can coordinate during our operations. Yes sir. Those Gundams were designed for fleet battles. Their high mobility is designed to allow the pilot to secure a superior position against the enemy. That's why they always come in twos, at least. The two of you didn't coordinate during that battle. Lieutenant Romfellow chased the enemy too much. Yes sir. Lieutenant Castle stayed behind you, protecting your machine and picking off the enemy at the same time. Huh? Well, a pilot can't just look at the enemy, you need to keep an eye on the entire battlefield. Yes sir. Have you ever heard of U-boats? 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 They were submarines used during the old era? World War II? Or World War I, I forgot. These submarines were a major threat against ships traveling in the ocean during that period. The reason they were so deadly was because the enemy could not see them. Your point, Luke? I'm talking about the tactics we're using. Those U-boats would sneak up on the enemy, sink it with a torpedo, and then get away undetected. In other words, we use our jamming field to do the same thing. That's the function of this 16th Independent Squadron. In other words, our 2 Gundams are the torpedoes. It's not actually that simple, but well, that's close enough, I guess. Just keep in mind how important it is to have both Gundams working together as a team. Alright. Understood, Lieutenant Ford Romfellow? Sir. Our ship is deep inside Xeon territory. Don't forget that this is a battlefield. Sir? Oh, yep. I had the right hunch. He had the spacesuit because he will be involved in the space beyond the blaze. Let me be clear, Xeon does not have the wherewithal right now to put a soldier returning from Earth on a ship, no matter what that ship's destination is. You have no idea what it took to get back here, there must be something, a supply ship maybe? Doesn't matter what you say, it's impossible. Is it because we're Foreign Legion? That's enough, Jake, let's think of another way. May, do you have an idea? I have to get you back home as soon as possible. If I go home, what will you do, Jake? You know what? I'll do. Return to the battlefield. Even if I can't rejoin them, once we win the war, they'll be saved too. What? Jake, don't be stupid. What? Huh? What's that mobile suit? Is that an Akzaku? I've never seen a machine like that. Is that a Zaku? Well, it's based on a Zaku. Of course it's not the same. Let's see. The field motor's magnetic field has an unusual shape. There's no doubt about it. This machine has magnet coating. Magnet coating? Hey, are you the ones who came up from Earth? How dare you abandon your comrades like that? Granada doesn't need selfish cowards like you around. Why? What? You look like you want to say something. Disgrace to Xeon? You. Leave it, Jake. Not here. You must be Miss May, I take it. Sir, I knew it. I was worried when I heard one of our treasured daughters of Kawin was at the front on Earth. Huh. Who is that guy? That's Lieutenant Marit Sanguine, or Mallet. I don't like him. He's a good mobile suit pilot, though. That Akzaku was brought to Granada just for him, all the way from Payson. That's proof right there of just how good he is. Wow, went out of their way for him, huh? Okay, another Zaku ace right there. That ends up being defeated by all Gundam pilots anyway, with the exception of Ken. This is Marit Sanguine. Welcome, Lieutenant. Sir, as you are aware, the war is not going well. However, Vice Admiral Dosley at Solomon is no fool. We are to send reinforcements to Solomon and Abao Ku, Zeon cannot be defeated as long as we're united. Reinforcements? Granada's strength shouldn't be spared for weaklings who can't even fight for themselves. Granada cannot survive on its own, you know. Look at the big picture. Sir, although the reinforcements are already organized, one of our reconnaissance units was destroyed in the former Side 2 show zone. A Federation ship might be hiding there. So I'd like you to escort the reinforcements. Understood. You can leave it to me. Good luck. By the way, Lieutenant. Huh? What is it you are fighting for? Of course, to win, sir. Independence of space noise? Isn't that the goal of this war? I think for individual soldiers, all they really want to do is continue winning in battle. Alright then, excuse me, sir. If the Federation wins, space noise will be looked down on as inferior again. But if Zeon... No, if the Zabi family wins... No. Best not to think of such things. Yep, it's pretty much the conspiracy for Zeon. It's not really to win as space noise, but rather just a hunger of power from the Zabis, since they even took over the Daikun. There's no mistake, Petty Officer Takizawa. Yes, the Zeon fleet has more than twice the strength of our squadron. I see. Please open up a special channel. I need to inform the entire crew. Yes, it's open, sir. Okay, that's the main story of Space Beyond Blaze side story. This specific time frame of going to, or at least for this stage. So, basing off of that, this happens before the raid of Solomon, so Dazzly is still alive. It's just as you say, Captain. No problem. The 16th Independent Squadron has me, Ford Ramfellow. Leave that Zeon fleet to me. They're less than nothing, less than less, not nothing. But what are you saying? This is the time for veterans like me and Captain Kirsten to shine. You can take a breather, young blood. Ah, you too. Remember what we talked about at the meeting? You have to work as a team. G04 and G05, prepare to launch immediately. Understood. G04 ready to launch. G05, equip that giant Gatling gun with enemies over a wide area. Alright, with this giant Gatling, I don't know, Gatling, I won't have nothing to fear. I could win by myself with this thing. Ford, did you hear that part about teamwork? Relax, you lose what little hair you have left, look. Enough with the goofing off, this is important stuff, Ford. Alright then, here's the mission briefing. First of all, the good news is that the enemy hasn't even detected us yet. Victory will be quite difficult unless we take full advantage of this fact. Which means we have to sneak up on them again, like last time. However, we cannot beat them by just hitting them with a surprise attack. So what then? G04 and G05 will be in front of the enemy fleet. This ship will then disperse Minovsky particles while setting a course for behind the Zeon ships. That makes sense. It'll take advantage of the weakness of Zeon ships. What weakness is that, Luth? Think about it. You'll figure it out, Fold. The design of a Musai. Oh yeah, a Musai only has turrets in front. Right. Zeon ships are vulnerable to attacks from behind. Exactly. Both G04 and G05 will attack from the front to draw out the enemy mobile suits. This ship will then hit them hard from behind. We have less fighting strength, but a pincer attack should work against the enemy fleet. What amazing tactics. Those Zeon guys won't know what hit him. Understood. Almost time for our move. Here I go, Luke. Teamwork, remember, Ford? Ford better not go bonkers again. Okay, there it is. They managed to sneak up on their behind, after all. We cannot communicate with the base, it's a jamming field. Jamming? What's the Federation doing in this sector? There are reports of a recon fleet getting hit. The odds are high that the Federation is hiding somewhere. I see, must be some kind of stealth unit. Fascinating. Launch all available mobile suits. Smoke out that Federation ship. Okay, we got a bunch of Doms. Some Zakus left from the start of the year. There it is, the Zeon fleet. There sure are a lot of them. Don't panic, Ford. Our mission is to lure out the enemy mobile suits. It's not to destroy those ships. I know, you need to stop worrying so much. Your hairline can take much more stress. Enough with the chatter. Time to start the operation. Alright, I'll tear him up. Alright. Since we are going in hard mode, I'm gonna use my original fleet. And some from this squad. Let's just see if we have enough SFS. Need one. I need two, I guess. No, this can... That's good, actually. It can perform in space. So, one, two. Only two, actually. So, it should be enough. Alright. Let's do this. So, we gotta destroy the Chive. This one, yep. Using... the thoroughbred. Should be easy considering we can just march in using chance steps to get to it as quickly as possible. We can start working on that right now. Yep, not very lucky right there. And they hurt, let's remember that. Up the SFS. I don't know, even if we get a chance step, we cannot move, so no use actually giving the Easy 8 a chance step. Instead, we're gonna give the Mad Rock. Okay, yeah. I gotta forget he has a very weak melee. Of course they would do that right now. I wasn't paying attention. Gotta be careful now. Those are just Zakus. Their stats are definitely buffed, I think. We can finally use the full vernier. Full vernier, it's not Bernern. I don't know who translated that, but it became normal. The Bernern. It's supposed to be vernier. That's what we have to be wary about. We cannot do double shots anymore. It's gonna be triple shots from now on to kill Zaku. And even more for Doms. Or probably the same, but still, a lot of work definitely is required. Let's just hope they give more XP though. That would suck otherwise. And this is a time where we actually have to utilize our defense supports and offense supports. Good thing we have a good squad on the left side as well. We can clean the Zakus. Oh, that is bad. Can we reach him with the Imcom? Nope. Got 5k. I think the Blossom can, or I'll start with the FA Mark III. Using leg hyper beam cannon, I guess. 54. It's not that they have good dodge, it's that Elfriede does not have a good range stat. Better off using beam sabers all day if you don't want to waste a turn. But they're not gonna die, so. This is the perfect chance for a support backup. There we go, it hit. It's as good as dead with Eterna's range stats, which is, I believe, around 300 even at level 16. Let's try a support attack again. This kills a lot more energy, but it assures Chen steps. That's the good part. Well, we could have attacked, but oh well. And I finally gave a resolution to the Barbados. Probably seeing in a while every time I end my episode with Goat being in the logo as my master with Barbados, and I didn't bother using it because it's too strong. I have no excuse in hard mode, so now's the perfect time actually. Good. Probably could do the same. Or not. Instead, I'll put her back. She could resupply early on. No ship or no deploy. Let's not forget these guys too. They're pretty strong units, so I wouldn't be benching them this stage. I still have the Thoroughbred challenge to worry about. Oh, we gotta be wary of the Dom cannons. And who knows if they're smarter. Who else? See a trio attack from these guys. Two incomes. That income looks badass though. And then we have Eterna. Using beam guns. Oh wow, they actually do that? Like beams scattering from every direction when it's a support attack. It's awesome. Oh yeah, that was not necessary. Okay, gotta be careful here. 28%. Shouldn't be scared, really, but you never know. There's a Shiva, yeah, it doesn't have captures either, so we just destroy it straight up. Damn, okay, that hurted. I have to give Shiro. Oh man, that sucks. Okay, then let's give Bork. So he has a chance step for supporting our team. We can do offensive supports. Let's start off with... There we go. Even that was enough. I have to finish with Madrock. Level him up at the same time. Okay, I forgot, let's review. I know we gotta kill that, but the regular... Okay, never mind. Just destroy the Chivai and something's gonna happen. Okay, now we can focus on the ships. Let's start off with... the Pixie. Okay, they're pretty tanky. Didn't expect that. could have attacked. Oh well. Oh damn. He hits much more than me. That's not good because that ship could destroy us next turn. Let's hope this hits. Alright, good luck. We have still the good luck. And no problem with Mark since he can just use feather funnels. Dealt 10k, shouldn't be bad. In that case, I think we can get rid of it even without the Barbados' help. So the Barbados can focus on a Chive. And luckily there's no time limit on this one, so... okay, let's first see how much HP will drop using the Barbados. K, sub 21k, and then we can use this girl's for chance step once he killed the Musai. Oh, that sucks. That is the worst thing to happen when you plan something. Oh god, these battleships. Gotta be careful of them, they're really strong. So that's another 6k and a good dodge. The G3. Good luck to the G3. Just hope it doesn't die. Yeah, right. We got this to finally finish it off. Oh, you know your range is bad. Hitting a battleship is less than 60. Okay, we're safe. G3 is safe for now. Okay, for good. We are gonna get rid of this. Use supports just to confirm it. Really? Come on. Okay, good thing that was enough. I wouldn't have settled for less than that. ...19k. If we use another pinpoint using the arm-mounted cannon, another 13k, and I know Thoroughbred deals 6k, so it'd be dead. Okay, 9k from the Pixie. Hopefully the Mudrock can finish it off. I believe in you. Yep. Finally, the Musai, or the Cheve. What did I use last time? I just used the missile barrage. There we go. Could have been a lot of XP, but we have our priorities. And there it is. Okay, there goes Merritt's team. some space doms and the Akazaku. Federation scum, there they are. Dirty rats are here for the cheese. Master Merritt, did you know the Federation was in this area? Of course, since they were spotted in the shoal zone, Federation rats are hiding in this sector. So, of course, they've come sniffing around now that the Xeon fleet has appeared in front of their eyes. We're actually using the fleet as a decoy? Lieutenant Merritt, those are our comrades in arms. We're fighting together to achieve independence. My eyes are focused on greater things than that. This war is just the first step towards a new Xeon that I will create. New Xeon? Himon, Lilia, Gustar, listen to me. We cannot lose. Engrave that on your heart. Only winning is allowed. So I could imagine this guy actually being the one to start the Neo Xeons. Even before Haman, if he survived this battle, but he died too bad. Or at least I know. I'm not sure. Victory, nothing less. We got Ina's Zaku. The Zaku 2 RD4 for space. So this is even more customized. It's good. Good for him. Okay, at least we know we have no more business at the bottom, so I hate maps like these. Makes you go all the way to the bottom, then pulls you back up and top. Definitely not. Very tedious. Shiro's fine. I really don't want to set up the SFS again, so just gonna use energy charge just in case he ends up needing to resupply. And no problem with the pixie catching up. He has very good movement. Might as well resupply the RX-78. And I'm not gonna stick too far, because those guys are gonna be obstructed by meteors, asteroids, so they're gonna need to get back into the ship and move with the ship. But yeah, that's pretty much it. This time we're grouped together. That's why I like space maps better. Less obstacles. Well, we have obstacles, but less maze, I mean. Like, it doesn't separate your team that much using structures. That way we know we can navigate with EXP boost. Well, should have put in Elfried before. But they're not gonna come except the secrets, so. Let's try a group attack. Not bad, I guess. Someone who can actually tank, because these guys I know are gonna hit a lot. And I'm pretty sure shoulder cannon is not enough. Yep, it's good. Yu is pretty squishy, so I'm not gonna have him just get countered by something that's nasty. Just sniping right now. That's good. So far, so good. I don't know, I wasn't able to check the quest, but it's probably hidden by now, but only thing I can think of that might trigger a quest, or might have me get a quest without even having to repeat the stage, is have Ford kill Sanguine. That's the only thing I can think of. I mean, most of those are obvious anyway, so... And it's not a big loss if, even if I lose just one XP from that. I'm gonna reserve the units on this side. No reason to deploy if we're not gonna kill him. Okay, now Marit and Ko are gonna move in. Just what we want. Oh, the ship. Oh, we have that. He has 25%. It's all good. Okay, that was close. It's like a big waste of XP right there. Two units we can actually give the XP. One to the Madrock or to the Hazel, but the Hazel needs to get a good chance step. In which case, I'm gonna hit one of these Doms to get it. I'm not sure if the exam changes. Okay, he's gonna hit me with a giant bazooka. That's gonna hurt. Just snipe her. It supports maybe. Hard point 7. Then a beam rifle shouldn't hurt now. Can cast the bazooka. Can still at 34, so I'll take it. Better miss. Yep. Good tidings. Not supposed to be using that. Not the right moment, but just thought about it. Damn, sorry, I'm retreating. Number one. I know this Zero has the XP boost as well, and AP boost boot. Okay, you know that. I should have used it on him. Now we can't reach him. I'm gonna need a chance step from that second Rick Dom too. I'll use a shoulder cannon, but let's just make sure it hits. We have no time to actually worry about getting a bad accuracy. A bad hit, so let's just use our shoulder cannon. Oh crap, he has support. Fudge. Even for the perfect Gundam, that hurted. Alright, then we gotta do some big work this turn. 6k ain't enough, I know. It's your chance, Ryer. Oh god. Okay. This guy hits a lot. It's just a beam rifle. Says a lot in this hard mode. That's not good. This is not good. You know what? I'll screw it. GP01 will steal this kill. At the same time, get close to the Madrock. The Madrock. Because we can't afford to lose the RX-78 and the others, so we have to be working on those units on the top as well. I'm stupid. I should have used the EXP boost from this on him and have him use it on him. I was being stupid. Oh well. I mean, those Zeons are not really harmful, but we gotta get rid of Merit. So let's work on him using our... We can still get rid of that. And might as well try with the Madrock. 47. With an exchange of that, it's not worth it. Same thing with Merit. It's going to be countering. So we actually have to get rid of it. Maybe these units are... Yeah, Freya. Can get rid of her or him. Without worrying about them dodging. Enemy or no, that was impressive. Human here, I'm done. That's some way to sign off. Okay. Still have the G's. If I commit on using these NPCs to hit him and get hit back, then I better really kill him this turn. Which I'm pretty capable, I just have to do the right stuff. This guy is ambitious. Boom. Okay, we know the beam rifle deals around 5k. Ouch. Yep, that hurted. You're definitely getting rid of this guy. Okay, I think the Phoenix funnels are enough to deal damage. Okay, perfect. 6k for a 5k. We might as well get rid of that last Rick Dom right there. And we are gonna get assist. That's the good part. Good crit. They got me. Let's see if these guys have good units. Nope. No captures for this stage. But this only means one thing, we're gonna be killing Merit. More like unlucky, it's time to get shot down. Where are my pilot cockpit cutscenes? If I'll nail you with the next one. Okay. I'm gonna start flanking the Zanzibar. That hurted. Felt that one. It's not even funny. I can't even dodge him. Oh lord. Is this the end? One more shot. They're out on this area. Not worth it. I'm just gonna travel up using the Mad Rock and get rid of everyone for good, because if he starts aiming these guys are safe based on our ranking or the damage he's dealt, but I know Freya is not safe since he dealt 8k, so I'm not gonna risk dodging that for the whole stage, and instead I'll just jump towards the goal using the Mad Rock. That's the problem though. Okay, you just need two from here, so. But if it's not. Okay, I'll just. I know what to do. So we need three from here, should be enough. This way we can still utilize skills from zero, and we're gonna use attack bursts to compensate for the lack of pinpoint when attacking the Zanzibar. And I don't think we are gonna need accuracy boost hitting the Zanzibar. Gotta make sure we kill this one though. So for that, we're gonna be giving him quick motion. Oh, 73. Don't I have anything better? Can we stack him? No. Oh, we have lock on. Okay. There we go. At least he got more ace points from that. Okay, keep pumping that range. You are gonna need it in the future. And then just to make sure. Oh, he is still in quick motion for one whole turn. Oh snap. It doesn't work on others. And high vigor. Oh, he was on high vigor. Oh boy. Strike assist. There we go. That should suffice now. Time to end this. I can't imagine artillery rounds being useful in space. Okay, that's pretty much it. We don't have captures, but we definitely earn a lot of cash just from the stage itself and the bonus from hard mode, which is 10k. So that's 40k total. And 50 more for ace points. Well, that's it for the beginning. Oh, it's kind of cool how we got Ford already. We don't have to finish the whole series, but based on my restrictions, I will not be using these guys yet. Got magnet coating. Pretty useful, but not as much. With the stats, that is only 5. But yeah, that's it for this episode, guys. Next episode, we're gonna keep going. Hopefully, we can maintain our hard mode status with all the good units I have, and if not, I'm gonna be grinding, I guess. Probably gonna keep hard mode for as much as I can, as long as it's tolerable. But yeah, make sure to wait or make sure to tune into the next episode and do all the fun stuff, like, comment, and subscribe. That is it. We'll be right back.